yourself again, if that's all right.
I'm Adam Shaw and I'm the lead coach of Motherwell Girls under 15's.
And if you wanted to.
I'm Lauren Simpson, I'm a centre back for Motherwell Girls under 15.
Okay, so how about coaching in terms of the club? When did you start doing that, when did you take on that role?
I joined the club 3 years ago now. When I first joined, I was in the 13s, Motherwell. And after the last 2-3 years, we've now moved up to 15, so it's a second year at 11 a side. The jump the first year was hard, but it's been a good 3 years for myself as a coach. I've developed, I've seen girls develop as well, so I think that's all you can ask for as a coach.
So you've sort of been through these last several years with the same sort of group of girls?
Yep, we've only seen 2 or 3 girls move on, but the majority of the group have stayed, which is obviously ideal for yourself as a coach and players, because it's familiar faces, you know what they're all about, and it makes life so much easier for you.
So in terms of the whole squad, how have you sort of seen the girls develop and improve as players over that period of time?
In the period of time, it's been massive. When I first joined, no disrespect to the girls, they couldn't really pass a ball, to be honest with you. I think Lauren will admit that herself. But just everything they've put in the last 3 years for myself and Maxine, the other coaches, just the attitude, the commitment has been ideal. And you can see that in the performance now. They're starting to gel. They're starting to become a good football team. Starting to become good friends on and off the park, which makes life so much easier for you as a football team.
So do you agree with that? Yeah. A big transformation over the couple of years?
Yeah.
How have you, in terms of as a player, rating your coach, how has your coach changed or improved over that time?
I'd say the two of them have improved better. They've learned to work together a lot and they've obviously helped us out lots.
And in terms of your coaching, what's the sort of the approach, the philosophy that you take to...
Well, my philosophy is I'm a big fan of watching Arsenal and Barcelona, so my philosophy for the girls is always just passing and possession football. It's the way I live by for football. It's all I love watching is teams keeping the ball. I love the girls to get the ball out for the back. I've always said to the girls, if we lose a goal from trying to play football, then it won't bother me, because at this age you can't discourage young players from trying to play football. In my opinion, football these days, I think it's just a case of winning. But when the girls, boys, whatever it may be at this age, it's development at the same time. So they need to learn how to play football first and foremost before results. But that's my opinion. I know people have got different opinions.
And how do you find that approach? Is that sort of liberating to know that your coach isn't sort of putting pressure on you just to focus on results? It's about enjoying the game and playing the right way.
Yeah, just it makes it a lot more enjoyable, I'd say, because you're not just playing for a win, you're playing to play football.
Do you think that helps the sort of camaraderie of the team, that it's about sort of you're playing for a higher kind of goal, you're looking to play good football that you can sort of be proud of, rather than just scraping to a 1-0 win that's all about just the end result?
Yeah, because really I think that the way we've played football has made us closer as a team, and I think it's really worked.
Does that suit your game as a sort of somebody who hadn't played the game and is getting coached into the game, that you're now sort of ball playing centre half in the professional game? There's not many central defenders that are particularly good at holding on to the ball and playing football and having it confident in their feet.
Yeah, I think because when we played sevens, it was more about not goals, it was more about keeping the ball and passing it and just playing football, really.
And how do you find combining the coaching and the sort of football side, which people can sort of relate to, but also with administrating, being in charge of organising girls and the structure of everything and all that sort of...
Off the park, do you mean? Away from... Yeah. I'm quite lucky because Maxine, the other coach, she does the majority of that for me, so it's just a case of me getting the footballs and the cones, and then I get to do my own stuff in the football part, but I do help a hand, and it's a lot easier. The club help us a lot. I know the girls play a monthly fee, but the club do majority of it, and when we want to help out, they let us help out, i.e. first tracksuits, fundraising, so we help that way, but we do get a lot of help from the club.
So you find that Motherwell SC are really sort of supportive of the...
Yeah, very supportive. They're looking to build a pathway for the girls, because there's a lot of girls dropping out of football. Motherwell feel if you build a pathway, then you'll get more faces in the game. So very supportive towards us, especially, and they're starting to do that towards the other clubs that are coming up.
And have you noticed a difference over those several years that you've been involved, like the number of girls playing football locally?
Well, big time. When I first joined, it was only 13s, 15s, and then it was a jump. There wasn't even a ladies team. It was just 13s, 15s when I first joined 3 years ago. Now the club have got a 9-a-side, under 11s, under 13s, 15s, 17s, and then we've now got a ladies team, and they're looking to make the step of a reserve team as well. So you can see it's a build, it's a work in progress, but the club are building for the future.
So that brings me on nicely to long-term visions. What are your both long-term aims or vision for the club, or and all that sort of stuff?
Well, next year, myself and Lauren, we both move up to 17s. This is Lauren's last year. My development personally as a coach, I've done 13s, I've done 15s, so I want to make that step up to 17s to see that I think it'll be more physical in the 17s game. So for me, it's ideal. I get to develop, I get to work out with a new coach. In the league, I'll be assistant coach to Jim Irwin, who's the 17s coach just now, so I can learn new stuff from him. For the girls' side of it, 9 of the girls currently in the team are moving up with me, so I think that's good for myself and the girls, because they still see me. Sadly for them, actually, they'll still see me at training. They'll still hear my moaning at the games, but I think it'll be next year, I think it'll be a big year for Motherwell 17s.
How about yourself, Lauren?
Just keep playing, just keep enjoying it, really. Just aim for that.